person and no industry immune from this pandemic, and now local farmers in our state are taking a major hit. Channel 3 Eyewitness News reporter Shantae Passmore is live in Falls Village tonight for us. Shantae?
Dennis, if anything, this pandemic has shown us how fragile the supply chain is right now. For dairy farmers, they are hurting. Demand is not what it used to be before COVID-19.
Tim and Caitlin Kinsella can't quite put into words what the pandemic has done to their dairy farm, as much as what it feels like.
I can best describe the pandemic as I've gotten whiplash.
While milk prices are steady at stores, the Birch Mill Farm owners say they're expecting to now receive a $15 average a unit this year. That's roughly a $4 drop before the pandemic. And losing money is only the tip of the iceberg.
The problem has been that farmers, there's no place for the milk to go, and you can't turn off the cows.
Farmer Don Tuller and president of the Connecticut Farm Bureau tells Eyewitness News about 10% of the dairy produced here is being dumped. There's still a demand, but it's shifted. With schools and many restaurants closed, dairy processing plants are shifting to make sizes grocery stores need.
We tried to react really fast, but there was no, you couldn't react as fast as you needed to.
During pandemic onset, supply couldn't meet demand as milk flew off the shelves. But the Kinsellas say demand has evened out. And even though home use consumption is up, it's nowhere near enough to make up for what the service industry purchased. The Kinsellas say it's not out of the question whether they might dump their milk. Meanwhile, the Farm Bureau reiterates the state's entire agriculture is affected.
We're concerned about losing farmers because they just can't maintain.
And the Connecticut Farm Bureau has gone so far to call what's happening now a train wreck on agriculture. It also went on to say about $2 million a month is needed for state dairy farmers to just break even during COVID-19. In Falls Village tonight, Shantae Passmore, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.